Hello, Zero K fans, and welcome to Nanolays at Dawn. I'm your host, ShadowFury333, and we're going to start out this week's exhibition match stream with a match that's 2v2, a request match. I can't remember who requested it because it wasn't their in-game name. They actually requested it on YouTube for some reason on my Dark Souls Let's Play. For the record, I'd like to keep the comments on topic, more or less, and also there are a lot of ways to contact me, but whatever. Anyway, we're going to be doing this match. So, it is a match between North Chilean G, Mr. Casanova, against Catastrophe and 2 plus 2 is 5 on Red Comet. So, without further ado, we have Catastrophe starting out with the Hovercraft Factory, as well as 2 plus 2 is 5 starting out with a Light Vehicle Factory against North Chilean G, the Cloaky Factory, and Mr. Casanova also going for the Light Vehicle Factory. Let's look at Mr. Casanova and 2 plus 2 is 5 going for a slightly different strategy. Mr. Casanova playing for the mid game right off the bat, only going for Scorchers for a bit of scouting and expecting to have to deal with enough Scorchers coming from 2 plus 2 is 5 to justify a leveler investment, or at least a bit of one. Leveler Slasher, that's an interesting choice. It's a good choice though, given what they are fighting against with light vehicles and hovercraft. That's a well-informed choice. I mean, it's probably an educated guess more than anything, but it is a well-informed, educated guess. Of all the things that I could think you could possibly do as an opening against hovercraft and light vehicles, Leveler plus Slasher is fairly high up there. That being said, though, it almost looks like Mr. Casanova is just building everything, like one of everything. So perhaps my praise is a little bit premature. At the same time, North Chilean G going for opening hovercrafts. Sorry, not hovercrafts. Opening warriors. Once again, probably to deal with the daggers. Though they might not be necessary, seeing as it looks like Mr. Casanova might just be focusing entirely on the southeast part of the map. And indeed, they're going straight for... Sorry, Mr. Casanova. That is, in fact, Catastrophe. Catastrophe going straight for that, and probably not doing much else besides... Looks like that is actually going to be a bit of... Ah, crap. That is going to be a possible problem for Mr. Casanova coming here, although at the same time, Mr. Casanova, that's the bigger problem. Their commander getting under attack shouldn't be under too great of a threat. Not enough units are there to defeat, but it's not out of the hot water yet. Thankfully, with a couple slashers coming in here, will at least be somewhat well defended. And at the same time, those Scorchers going straight into a warrior, straight to their death. So at this point, I'd say North Chilean G, the Eastern team, in general, they are doing all right. They are winning the unit war. They're just, however, not really... They're not that far ahead economically, but it's fine. This is really just the territory grab phase. On this map, you aren't really going to see a whole lot changing because of unit efficiency up until the point where the map has been split in half. And at this point, West has taken quite a bit of the map, being very aggressive too, throwing in a few static defenses here and there. But compared to their opponents, it's actually, well, about the same. I mean, a couple defenders, so the extra range is there in case of glaives coming in there, but I don't think that's going to happen. North Chilean G is going entirely Warrior Rocker. They have a couple glaives built up, which they might use to scout around a bit, but a few defenders, that's okay, that's handy to stop scouting. Certainly handy to stop raiding. But the glaives should be able to at least get around the parts that aren't filled with defenders, and that's quite a bit of the map, all things being considered. So at this point, really, North Chilean G is already prepared for dealing with defenders. It's a 2v2, so you don't really get a lot of that early game raiding. You get a bit of it, but it's not like 1v1. 1v1, you get about 3 to 5 minutes of pure raid mode. 2v2, it can, but because you have two players and all the build power in there and the economy grows that much faster, usually the raid phase is much shorter as a result. Now, we are seeing a few daggers run around, but we already saw, like, right off the bat, levelers and warriors, and that's not a bad idea because there's enough ground to cover. Like, because we have Mr. Casanova in the center, they can just handle everything coming from the south, and North Chilean G can handle everything coming from the north, and it all works out just fine. There aren't really any issues about mobility or anything, or covering ground, or losing territory, because as it is, I mean, East Team does have a fairly low amount of territory. It does seem like West Team going forward is going to have a much easier time maintaining economic dominance in this game, and they are going for the Raiders, so that's still important. However, at this point, we are seeing a bunch of Scorchers once again going to their deaths, and that's some juicy reclaim. 200 metal worth of reclaim right there. On top of that, there's another 120 metal-ish over here, or 100 metal over here over to the south. So there's quite a bit of reclaim to be had, and that is exactly what North Chilean G is doing. Thank you, North Chilean G! Finally, people are getting... I mean, not finally. It's just... some of the last matches I casted last week, there were a few times where I was going, please get Reclaim. Why are you not getting Reclaim? Come on, it's right there. And North Chilean G is doing that. So I'm glad. At the same time, though, not a whole lot of metal has been donated to the Western team. East team has been very defensive. They've been just slowly expanding forward, slowly creeping out of their base. And that does mean that they kind of rely on Reclaim for economic parity. But they are taking advantage of it, so that's good. Like, they need to. They are. Good thinking. Now, the Western team, on the other hand, like I said, they have a massive territory advantage. That is growing. And it looks like East team might be going for a bit of a retaliatory strike, or at least trying to possibly break some of the territory grabs. If that Quill was killed, that would have been fairly big, but I don't think it would have been worth the risk. However, at the same time, there is a bit of a border skirmish going on over the northern side of the map. A few rock is being built up. The push is now hitting the territory that has been established by the Western team. So this is where you're going to start to see unit efficiency become fairly important, especially with the workers nearby and all the reclaim that that means. And if... Okay, weird. Sorry about that. But yeah, the warriors going forward, I mean, that's going to be... Any slashes coming through, or sorry, scorches coming through, they're dead. The ravagers coming through, that'll be interesting. The Rockos will help against that. The warriors might work. The warriors are a lot of damage. The ravagers are quite high HP, but not a whole lot of damage themselves. So I don't think they'll be able to deal with the warriors without getting torn to pieces. And indeed, that's exactly what's happening. The warriors actually having a bit of a hard time not killing each other in the process, as they are able to get rid of the Ravagers very efficiently. Only one Ravager getting through that entire line, and it is at half HP. And of course, at the same time, you have all the reclaim going on as well. Unfortunately, the Warriors are out of position to help save their comrades over here. The Conjurer might die if it's able to escape. It's not able to escape, getting two-shot by the Ravager. Luckily for North Chilean G, a tick was placed in the northern side of the map to stop one of the Ravagers from getting in, but the Norman's Land has been established in the northern side of the map. Further south, though, it looks like a bit of a no-man's land has also been established thanks to the Wolverines coming out from Mr. Casanova. And 2 plus 2 is 5. Are they going for reclaim here? They are indeed. And how much reclaim do they have to work with here? So they have about 200 metal reclaim, about the same amount. So they are managing to maintain a quite hefty economic advantage. This is what I mean by the territory thing, though. And here, again, we have the Raptors coming through the Warriors, but at this point, I don't see it working out in favor of 2 plus 2 is 5. They've lost a lot of warriors to this. Their only saving grace at the moment is that there aren't any conjurers right near this reclaim pile. Like, that's a lot of reclaim, though, to take. That's almost 1,000 metal. That would be enough. Like, you know, you could have 3 or 4 workers come in, 3 or 4 conjurers come in, and just take that for about, like, 3 or 4 minutes. And have economic parity for 3 or 4 minutes, if not a slight economic advantage, without taking the territory yet. And the thing is, the southeast has not been taken at all. Mr. Casanova is going for it, but they're being very slow about it. That's one thing I would actually point out, is that they are being slow about taking the southeast side of the map, and it's possible that Catastrophe might actually realize that and just go for it. At the same time, 2 plus 2 is 5, going for Heavy Tank Factory. Looks like they might have been trying to go for Firewalkers as well to help get rid of the Wolverine mines, but I guess they figured the Wolverines weren't as big of a deal. There aren't very many claws on the field right now, so I don't think it's a big problem. However, at the same time, the northern side of the map missed... Ooh, North Chilean G is doing a number on Catastrophe's forces right now. Well, Catastrophe and 2 plus 2 is 5. Both of them having a hard time maintaining a strong presence in the northern side of the map as the push is continuing, and the southern side of the map, well, it hasn't been taken yet. It has not been taken by anybody. The only thing is that there are so many defenses here. I can kind of see why it's difficult to defend otherwise, but that is slowing down the eastern economic growth. Thankfully, though, at least for them, North Chilean G does have the reclaim going forward on the northern side of the map, so they will be able to maintain economic parity more or less for the next couple minutes. Anyway, the Heavy Tank Factory is done for 2 plus 2 is 5. Going for the Banishers, probably to basically outrange the Warriors. And similarly, the Scalpel's coming in here to help outrange the Warriors, getting hit by some ticks, but there's not much of a follow-up force for that, as the Warriors coming in are going to get killed by the Scalpels in the back lines. And, ooh, that's going to hurt. A couple Scalpels are dying, but this is nowhere near efficient. With the Banisher in here as well, like, the efficiency just went down by 100% for the eastern side, just in that one fight alone. Of course, with Rapiers in play, that'll help out there. And over further to the south, Looks like there is a strike against the defenses. We are seeing whether or not there are enough defenses here for Mr. Casanova. I mean, they were paranoid of this exact situation, and it has happened. And it looks like they still do not have enough defenses, ironically, despite all of their efforts. I mean, granted, halberds are pretty much the unit to get rid of defenses. But yeah, the entire southeast side of the map is going to be taken over by Catastrophe. This is exactly what I was pointing out earlier, is that Catastrophe at some point is probably going to take this, because it hasn't been taken yet. And indeed, that's exactly what's happening. So Mr. Casanova getting kind of surrounded without very many ways to expand. And of course, the no man's land in the center of the map maintaining its no man's land status. But if you look at the way that that's being set up, like, there is so much more territory control over from the western side. The eastern side has this section here, basically, like this here. That's what the eastern side has. That's it. The western side, on the other hand, they've got the other three quarters of the map, essentially. And these halberds are ensuring that's the case. Unfortunately, not very many Scorchers were built by Mr. Casanova, so they don't have a great deal of options against the halberds that don't involve just hoping for the best that they'll open up. Because the halberds can easily just come in and open themselves up right next to any of these units. They don't have to worry about getting into fights that they can't win. Scorchers, on the other hand, kind of force the damage anyway. Still, the northern side of the map, North Chilean G is maintaining a strong presence there, and even with the Banisher helping get rid of the rapiers, or helping splash out the rapiers can just avoid them. Get rid of the daggers, and yeah, to take the north from here, so it looks like we might see a north-south split, actually. And 2-5 reclaiming every factory but their heavy tank factory as well. They're all in the heavy tanks, though they aren't really building much at the moment. Looks like most of the money is going to Catastrophe, and at the moment that is not as much as they would like, I'm sure, because there is a lot of excess coming in from the western side. They only have enough energy for 55 metal production, so they are excessing. That's not great. Not terrible, and Mr. Casanova has managed to get a wall set up as well, which is kind of clever. But at the same time, the rapiers over on the north side of the map forced back, so the banishers coming in too close to deal with. Same time that the warriors are in here, and the halberds will have a hell of a time dealing with them. Like, this is pretty much the right force to use. Unfortunately, the chainsaw is also the right answer to those rapiers. A couple of them still survive, but they basically have nowhere to go. There's too much flex AA and dedicated AA coming from the western side of the map for rapiers to have much free reign. That being said, the warriors, because of that dedication to AA, the warriors are having a field day here. Unfortunately, only able to get a lot of... Actually, no. Fortunately, able to get a lot of power plants. Not unfortunately. Those solar plant kills are quite important. I mean, looking at the money right now, West just lost about 8 power. And as it was, that was one of the things keeping them in the economic lead, or this production lead, based on their economic advantage. Now, at this point, the eastern side is still relying a lot on reclaim. But at least managing to retake the southeast side of the map, and there is... How much reclaim is here? There, come on, show me the numbers. 1,500 metal! 1,500 metal worth of reclaim over to the southeast side of the map. So that's a good 3 minutes at economic parity right now. Sorry, 5 minutes at economic parity. And the eastern side of the map is taking, or rather, well, some of the eastern side of the map is taking quite a bit. Probably from the north, because that has been pretty well established. Well, no, actually. Oh, maybe the caretaker. At any rate, I kind of like these buried caretakers Mr. Casanova's doing. They're kind of tricky to deal with. They're not likely to be an immediate target either, because they're not going to be seen easily, and they're able to get the reclaim no problem. That's really clever. They stick one over down here. That would actually help a ton to take all of this reclaim and just push the east side over the top. Yeah, the western side has lost most of the northern side of the map. The Banisher's doing what they can to keep the northern side roughly in check. But even then, it's a bit weak over there. That being said, all the pressure to the south is causing the north side not to be hit as hard, so it's not as big of a deal. They can work around it. But even with that, the western side is still losing a bit of the force over to the south, which does mean that we could see a northern push. I don't think this is going to happen, though. I think that we are still going to see a lot more pressure on the south side of the map. Catastrophe is putting a lot of pressure. They've lost some of the southern expansions they've taken earlier, but they still have all these scalpels here and the daggers coming in as well, and they're still going heavily for a southern expansion. So there's way too much pressure going in the south, and the north actually coming in as well. This might be the end of the game. 2+2=5, having to deal with the snipers, that's, or the specters rather, that's like the one thing keeping them at bay at the moment. and it's not much. I mean, once the reload comes in, we should see maybe a couple of the banishers die. Yes, one down. The other one's going to be able to get away. So at least the north side has been defended fairly effectively. But the south side, this is the thing that might end it. Or maybe there's enough claws here that it won't. I mean, for reference, claws deal in total 200 damage, and daggers have 300 HP. But it doesn't matter. The daggers are going straight into the main lines, not even going for anything but the commander, pretty much. Trying to be careful from the looks of it, but yeah, they're going straight into the middle. They want that commander dead. They're out for blood. However, that is a level... No, it's a level 1 commander. 3600, because it is the siege commander. Sorry, guardian chassis. I forgot those renamed. But this is still going to be a bit tricky to deal with. The glaives trying to force them into the claws from the looks of it, and that will be successful. No, it won't be successful, but at least it'll push them away. Still, the south side is heavily pressured. The north side, however, has no pressure, and the specters coming through completely unopposed. The rapiers could probably come in as well and tear apart... No, they can't. Never mind. Chainsaw's there. But the specters could come in unopposed. Tear apart masons. That is wonderful, getting rid of the reclaim. But still, the western side way ahead economically, but the specters can continue tearing apart what they can. Mostly metal extractors. That's the best thing to have. But at this point, the northern side, fairly weak. All the forces are split to the southern. And the north... Northern defenses are gone. The southern defenses, however, for southern defenses for Mr. Casanova are also not in great shape. And North Chilean G might lose the commander right now. One more banisher shot will do it, but it looks like that's not going to happen. They are instead focused more on the rapiers, but this one last banisher could come in here. North Chilean G, why are you not moving your commander? That's going to die. Oh, wow. Saved by a claw mine messing up the targeting. Holy crap. How does that commander not die? Oh, whatever, it's not dead, and we apparently have gone into Doomsday Machine territory. Granted, with all the reclaim that they have right now. I mean, considering you have commanders right here. I think this commander has nanolithe. Yes, it does. So it's got like 20 metal build power. 17 build power. And on top of all the caretakers in the front of the map, or front of this area here, this wall. I mean, the north side is still a little bit weak, though. Like, neither player really has control, or neither team has control over it. South side is getting a bit more securely into Mr. Casanova's hands. But it is still a bit of the weak side. And the DDM, kind of nice to have, but it's still only going to be so useful. So I'm imagining we're going to see Catastrophe attacking really hard south from now on. Because attacking the middle of the map is going to be suicide without some strong artillery units, and I don't think we're going to see those. We have the penetrators up, but they're straight line artillery, so I'd be surprised if they actually managed to have a line of sight on the DDM. Still, the north side, though, like I said, was weaker, and the forces coming in of the Panthers to try to deal with what they can, and actually doing a not bad job, but still not managing to do much more than donate metal. And the damage dealt, I'd say, is a little bit minuscule. I would like to see a little bit more put into the north from North Chilean G, though. Like, retake that. Rebuild some of these areas. These two conjurers here, get them working. And then from there, probably put some defenses up as well, just to make it a bit harder to get through the north, because the north side is the weak side for both sides. Although the Stardust coming in here... Oh, no, Chainsaw coming in here. Never mind. No Stardust, just the Chainsaws. So yeah, from ground forces, the north side's really weak. The south side's only got the fact that that's where Catastrophe has been pressuring, going for it. North Chilean G's commander is about to go down with the... Scalpel missile, why did the commander go that far forward? What are you doing? Okay, that's wiser. Dig yourself into a hole. Don't die. I mean, it's not a huge deal because North Chilean G does have extra storage, but I think they do. They had extra storage. Oh, it's Mr. Casanova that has extra storage. North Chilean G might have extra storage. I have not seen it. I don't actually know. So North Chilean G might want to be a bit careful there. Still, the south side taking a huge amount of pressure. The north side getting forced back again. Like I said, this is not really consistent one way or the other. The chainsaw is finally becoming a bit of a problem, but the chainsaw could be a bit too far forward. In fact, these Panthers aren't played carefully enough, and they don't have much splash, so they actually have to be really careful unless they get killed. Actually, the glaives will be super careful how they kill them, but if the glaives manage to get in off, they managed to get in. If they didn't have to kill the Panthers, and the Panthers' deaths didn't stop them. Could have gotten rid of the chainsaw, but at this point, it's not working out. The south side is still defended again. Actually, counterattack coming in here from Mr. Casanova. We missed the defense, unfortunately, but the counterattack from Mr. Casanova might get rid of one of the penetrators. It's still reloading. That's clearly the target. And one of them does go down. The other one's still alive, about to reload. Should be able to take out of one of the Ravagers. No, it's not even able to. Why is it not targeting them? What the heck? No, whatever. Okay, so one. Oh, it's hold fire. That's why. Hasn't been ordered to target them, which kind of sucks. Catastrophe not paying attention to that because it does mean they have a possibly dead commander if they're not careful. No, this shouldn't work. No, the Halberd's also helping out. The Ravager, however, should be able to tear apart the entire north side of the map, though. Kill the flails, kill the metal extractors. Basically flank from behind, opening up the northern side of the map to... Well, not much, actually, because there's not much else happening. But if the Ravager does get through to the chainsaws and kills them, that would be amazing, because I can't imagine that would actually be allowed up to that point. But also, that would open things up for air forces. And North Chilean G's air force is pretty terrifying. There is a reason why we have those caretakers there coming from the western side. There is something to deal with. And another dug-in caretaker coming in to help reclaim, because that is what Mr. Casanova does. And like I said before, that's a pretty good idea. Actually, it is a pretty good idea. It's kind of difficult to deal with. Still, while the trench warfare is working fine for them, the northern side is falling apart a bit, and North Chilean G might actually benefit from using that exact same technique. Like, I feel like there's got to be a major weakness to dug-in caretakers. I mean, for one thing, you do have to terraform it, so they're more expensive than normal caretakers. But yeah, there's not much. Like, something dug-in like that is kind of difficult to deal with. The only problem is that, of course, it's a caretaker, so it isn't mobile. So you have to have a specific area you're defending in order for the reclaim to be relevant. But still, you set up enough of them, and then, yeah, it becomes really easy to just maintain reclaim throughout a fight. As everyone's losing units, you get all the reclaim. That's still pretty huge. Regardless, it looks like the northern side is falling apart. These chainsaws, another one built even further forward. These chainsaws coming in from 2 plus 2 is 5, they're basically determining the northern fight. Like, if they weren't there, 2 plus 2 is 5 would probably have been destroyed by now. But because of them, there's no way that any of this investment North Chilean G has in the Air Force, which is substantial, by the way. This is 3,000 metal. Like, that is, right now, 30 seconds worth of investment, but still, compared to, like, glaives, for instance, this is 900 metal worth of glaives. So, that would be, like... Well, that would be about 45 glaives, which, I mean, against Panthers are kind of useless, but if you had Roccos, it would be a bit more useful, and about the same number of Roccos, and there's a lot of things you can do for 3,000 metal that wouldn't get completely countered by a chainsaw right now. And we can see that North Chilean G has long since stopped making air forces, it's just they do have the investment that hasn't really paid off. And Mr. Casanova focusing again on more DDMs, not getting metal extractors. I can kind of see why it's a bit difficult to take them. And there are a few that have been taken over to the south, but it's like we have 5 workers right here. They're all working on a DDM, and I can kind of see why, because they'll probably get the metal extractors in the shadow of the DDM. But of course, while that's happening, we have 2 plus 2 is 5 over to the north, trying to find some angle to get in here. And a couple Zeuses and a warrior won't be enough to deal with this, as the Panthers probably will be able to just rip through everything right now. Although, imagine a few of them dying will stop the entire force, but none of them are dying, at least not until they get close enough to be threatened by the air forces here. But even then, that's it. And the chainsaws are in enough that there's no way North Chilean G can defend his own base with air units without losing them. This is a gambit on their part to try to stay alive by using these air units. These air units are done. Sheesh, that chainsaw usage. I don't really ever see that. I mean, it's viable in 1v1. You just don't see it very often. And it looks like North Chilean G completely falling apart. The northern side has been completely wrecked. Mr. Casanova is still doing a fine job holding the line in the south, but they're going to get flanked hard in just a moment. Like, as soon as that's all done, that's over. North Chilean G will be pretty much losing everything in a sec, and Mr. Casanova, they've got their walls set up. Like, it's going to be hard to break through them, but the problem is there's a big opening over to the north. And I don't think Mr. Casanova has the tools to deal with it. Not to mention all the reclaim there, too. All the fields of reclaim I was talking about earlier, all to the western side. All to 2 plus 2 is 5. That heavy tank switch was pretty wise. However, looks like most of this game is going to be consisting of grinding down Mr. Casanova into the dust, trying to take out their walls. Or just coming from the north and forget all that. I mean, flanking them is not going to be hard. There aren't any wall setups here. There are some claws, and there are some static defenses, but there's not much else. Still, there is economic parity between the two sides, so it's going to come down to whether or not this giant mass of panthers, two dozen panthers coming over to the north, can be dealt with before they flank out everything that Mr. Casanova has built, and or if there's some kind of counterattack that'll come in from Mr. Casanova and North Chilean G that can actually break through with there. Because the economic parity is on their side, and so is the... Oh, never mind. Actually, the attrition is going to the western side right now. Yeah, so is the attrition. The attrition has been... Wait a sec. No. East has destroyed fewer units. But more metal. East has destroyed more metal worth of units. That's the thing I was trying to point out. So yeah, the eastern side... They still have a 5,000 metal attrition advantage right now. So they're actually doing really well. Like, they have an economic parity, if not advantage sometimes. They do have a catapult to deal with, which is a bit of a problem. I was wondering when that was going to happen. There's going to be a Strider hub at some point, and there it is. The Dante on top of that. As well as the Dante coming in from North Chilean G, and that's what I figured would happen. Thing to point out, though, is that there aren't anywhere near as many defenses from our Western players here. There's actually not much that would stop a dedicated force from getting through to their base. That is one big difference right now, is that basically we do have 2 plus 2 is 5 trying to defend up the north with chainsaws, but otherwise there isn't much stopping them. Like, if you really look at what's there, this flank from the Panthers is basically all that the western side has, and if they lose that, then they're gonna be hit pretty hard by the Dante and whatever other forces happen to follow through with it. Now, the eastern side being ahead on metal attrition and also having a load of reclaim inside their base. Like, the eastern side might be able to actually deal with this no problem, and the DDM about 30 seconds away from getting done. Oh, but that's clearly priority, and I agree with that. It's just getting rid of these Panthers, it's still tricky. There's still 14 left of this one assault group, and another 3 coming in the back. But man, those levelers, that's perfect usage. So, for the time being, it looks like 2 plus 2 is 5 has been somewhat pushed back, but once again, the territory is kind of like 3/4 belonging to the western side. That being said, the northern section is essentially unclaimed. There's a lot of metal extractors that have not been taken. And while we do see a lot of turtling up from the eastern side, this is still... Like, it's still, like I said, attrition advantage, like 10,000 metal attrition advantage to the east. On top of the fact that getting through them is extremely difficult. And they have roughly economic parity. Actually, an economic advantage at the moment thanks to the reclaim from those Panthers that came in. So, it's actually working out pretty well for them. Like, they're not doing too badly overall. And there's one Dante. Second Dante is coming in, but this one Dante should be able to tear apart most of the Panthers trying to retreat. And with those gone, there isn't much stopping the north side from being torn to pieces. And that's exactly what's going to happen. The Dante's just wrecking everything. Might be stunned in the process, and yeah, will be stunned in the process. Not quite yet, but soon enough. Still, able to get rid of most of the Panthers, and there should be a follow-up force pretty soon. The Slashers here just need to move a little bit further north. Like, right now, actually. Like, right friggin' now. Well, at the very least, there are some impalers to deal with that, but still, that was dangerous. Yeah, the stunned Dante needs workers repairing it. That being said, the north side has basically been retaken. Like, the east players have retaken the north part of the map, or the northeast part of the map. Or at least have broken the hold. They need to still actually claim it for themselves, but that's something. Of course, at this point, the next problem is moving forward and actually breaking through the western lines. Because there aren't a lot of mobile units right now. There's some Striders, of course. Oh! I think 2 plus 2 is 5 might have actually given up here. This is This is going to be a bit of a problem going forward for the Western team. I mean, now we have essentially 1v2. And North Chilean G, however, has also lost most of their construction right now. It looks like they're focusing entirely on building up a bunch of Ravagers on top of the Dantes. They don't even have the gunship plan anymore. But Strider War is coming in right now. I mean, it's still a massive economic advantage and a massive attrition advantage over to the eastern side. It is basically a matter of get rid of the things your opponent has and you can break through, because the only thing is the military is roughly even. I point out attrition because, I mean, basically we have seen a lot of efficiency coming out from the eastern side, especially with all the static defenses built up. But the thing is, they don't have much of a force that can actually tear apart what's there. I mean, the Brawler is going to help. Like, the Brawler supported by Dantes, that'll do a lot of damage. But the question is whether or not it can actually maintain all of that. And that can actually keep pushing, because a lot of what they are using is reclaim, and that reclaim will eventually run out. It's going to take a while, but eventually it will run dry. And it looks like that eventually actually is about now. So the western side still with a bit of a military advantage. They essentially have a Strider's worth of Reapers on top of having a couple Striders of their own. And the two Dantes coming in, both of them... Oh, the second one here is just about healed up. So 2v1 Dante fight should be in favor of the Dantes, but the Ravagers against the Reapers should be in favor of the Reapers. See how this works, but the Dante is not helping out the Reapers, whereas the Ravagers are being helped out and slightly incinerated by their Dante. So I still say the Eastern team is going to win this, and yeah, they're pushing back the Reapers. Very few of the Reapers have died so far, but it looks like that's not going to last forever. And of course, the Impaler support on top of that has just been tearing apart the lines. So this is, like, it's, the problem is that once it gets past around the midpoint, once it gets outside of Impaler range, so about here, once it gets outside of this area, there's a lot of Impalers. Once it gets inside of, yeah, really? That's a lot of them. Okay, never mind. Once it gets outside of this range, like in this area here, where the red circles are, that is basically where we can't see the Western team fight and win. It just won't work. But outside of that, the Western team can't really have anything to worry about. Like, the Eastern team can't do much. So that's the predicament they're in right now. They have a strong defensive position, but they don't have a lot of ways of converting that into a strong offense. The best they can really do is essentially just force a bunch of reclaim into their base and get even more money, and then just slowly build up a giant army and then steamroll. Emphasis on slowly, it is going to take a while for that to happen. And over to the south, I mean, there are some attempts to break the line a little bit. Impalers from Catastrophe as well. But it's not really working out. With the Pillagers up here over breaking apart the north, this might actually end that area of the northwest that's still pretty safe. It might no longer be that safe. That being said, though, there should be a couple more Dantes here. Okay, yeah, both the Dantes are there. Both of them are alive. Both of them are getting healed up. So at this point, pretty much a stalemate. I mean, the Catapult doing what it can to break up the lines and try to break up the military advantage, because that's what the Eastern team has to do. They have to make sure that the military advantage does not maintain... It does not get maintained, and I don't know if that's going to happen. There are, like, 11 Reapers coming in here. Holy crap. 11 Reapers on top of the Catapult, on top of the Dante. Unless that died. I don't think that died. I don't recall seeing a Dante explode and fall down. Pretty sure it just retreated. Yeah, there it is. Right here. Dante's still good. So the western side still hasn't lost a whole lot of its firepower. Still has a pretty large economic advantage. Or sorry, not economic advantage, large economic engine. It's actually slightly disadvantaged. But a lot of heavyweight units coming in here, so I don't know. It's still pretty tough to deal with. And the northern side, again, remains fairly weak. The Dantes are, however, back in position to strengthen the lines. And if they stop all the Reapers coming in here, that will probably be it. That's basically the military that exists for the western side. Like, their hopes and dreams are all pinned on these 11 Reapers. And possibly those 10 Reapers, I'm not actually sure. Yeah, 10 Reapers now. And it's just a matter of keeping them alive. Like, it really is a question of neither team really feels confident that they can push forward. Although I think that the Eastern side has a bit of a chance. Going for the Bantha just as a guarantee. It's going to take a long time for that to happen, but just as a way of guaranteeing that it gets built. That something gets built. Probably should focus on that specifically, though. They do have an advantage of Dante's. Like, the Dante gap, that disfavors the Western side. That favors the Eastern side. But I don't know. This is really, it's more a matter of the Reapers, and the Reapers going down, the Dante's still alive. The firepower overall is in favor of the East. And certainly the economy is in favor of the East, so rebuilding from here is going to be a lot easier for the Eastern team. The problem, once again, is that the northern side of the map doesn't have anywhere near the defense that the southern side has, and one of the Dantes is about to go down if it's not careful. He needs to fall back. Well, actually, come to think of it, the Dante is, in fact, the Western Dante, as... ooh, almost... it might go down. Yeah, it's going down. It's going way too far in here. Should be an impaler shot or two that takes it out. Ooh, no, just barely missing. Possibly the catapults will take it out, though. And at the same time, the Reapers are coming in the back lines. There it is! The catapult shot does take out the Dante. And the Reapers in the back lines causing a bit of havoc. But at the same time, Leveler and Scorcher over to the south side of the map also causing havoc. Very slowly, but still slowing down a bit. Tearing apart a few power plants here and there. Although, admittedly, with the Singularity Reactor... holy crap, seriously? No, okay, that might have been a mistake. I mean, I get the overdrive is kind of important, but the Singularity Reactor at this stage, especially without the connection to the rest of the map here, that's not working out too well. Like, the military advantage is starting to turn around here. Like, really hard. The southern side is falling apart, and yeah, the east takes it. There wasn't much else. I mean, the eastern side had the economic advantage. There was no easy way for the western side to break them. They had the attrition advantage the entire game. I mean, if you look at the stats here, metal income was overall about the same, really. It kept going back and forth. Metal used, though, West had much more metal used and more metal produced as well, a bit more excess. But unit value maintained Eastern advantage the entire game. And that's bearing in mind, there was a slight metal use advantage on the Western side. The West built fewer units despite that. Really? Fewer units? Oh, that's not the worth. The unit value is an important thing. Yeah, the Western unit value got it caught up around that point, around the 20-minute mark, but it never exceeded, even though the use was always in favor. The Western side always had a slight economic advantage. If you look at what they actually had in total. That was the power of attrition. I'm really glad I started using this attrition counter. Holy crap, that is handy to figure out what's going on in the game. Thank you, Anarchid. I am so sorry I was not using that before. I still kind of wish that it was a bit more even-handed. Like, it wasn't just, you know, greater than 100% is one side, less than 100% is another side, like a sliding bar or something. Or like a number that was like 100% or more for east or 100% or more for west. I don't know, something. Or plus for one side or plus for the other or zero. Like 160 would be like plus 60 east or... 40 would be plus 60 west. I don't know. Something that makes it seem a little bit more even-handed and less a matter of me versus them. Because right now it's treating whoever's on the left as the player, as you. But yeah, cool feature. Really neat. Made the analysis of this game a lot easier. Holy crap. That's a wonderful tool. And yeah, the east dealt way more damage the entire time as well. I mean, we can see here that was a big part of it. They dealt more damage, they received less damage. They kept a unit value advantage the entire game, even if they had not really a unit amount advantage the entire game. I don't know why units build is... I think I know what it is. Claws, I think, count as units built. But they don't obviously count as value since they don't cost anything. I think it costs like 5 or something. What is their value? Yeah, the value is 5. So they don't count for unit value much, and that actually skews the graph too. But they do count for units produced. That actually skews a lot, I think. I'm guessing that's why, because it wasn't like there were fleas or anything massively cheap. Oh, unit value. I don't know if it shows the cost of terraform when you terra build. Like this. I have no idea. I doubt it. I don't know how you'd evaluate that, because... yeah, you'd be able to mark it if the terraform command is performed as part of the build command. Like, you build and then you change the height. But I don't think that's implemented internally as... one command. I think it's a terraform command then a build command queued up after the terraform command, so it's just terraform. I don't think that necessarily works that way. Anyway, the next match is going to be between Felthas and Lamedeus on Titan Duel, so stay tuned for that. It'll be up in a couple minutes. And yeah, if you're wondering about the team games, as mentioned before, this was a request, and while I don't typically do team games on my own, I will do them by request up to 3v3. So anyway, stay tuned for the 1v1 next, because it's 1v1 next.